Another proof that there was an imposter, Sister Lucia, is the fact that the real Sister Lucia would have never accepted the new Mass. In fact, the imposter, Sister Lucia, would even receive, quote, communion from the other sisters of her convent. Also, when the imposter, Sister Lucia, received, quote, communion from John Paul II at Fatima on May 13, 2000, she engaged in totally bizarre activity by kissing John Paul II's hand immediately after receiving, quote, communion from him. I have never seen or heard of anyone else in the world ever kissing a priest or bishop's hand right after Holy Communion was put into their mouth. This activity was so incredibly strange that there are almost no words to describe this scene. This by itself is proof positive that this person was most certainly not the real Sister Lucia. After kissing John Paul II's hand, she asked one of her bodyguards if she could stay on the altar with John Paul II, as John Paul II continued to distribute, quote, communion to the other people. This is as bizarre as kissing his hand right after, quote, communion. But the message that the devil wanted to convey was quite clear. John Paul II is the hero of the Third Secret. He is so great and so holy, when the truth is just the opposite. John Paul II was an anti-pope. He was a total heretic, schismatic, and apostate, as we prove in our video, Why John Paul II Was Not the Pope. One of the ways that we know that the imposter Sister Lucia fully accepted the apostasy of Vatican II was because she made her own outrageously heretical statements. For example, in 1992, she was reported as saying, quote, God condemns no one to hell. And on March 25, 1997, the imposter Sister Lucia claimed to finish a book called Calls from the Message of Fatima. The Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith authorized this publication. And on pages 195 and 196 of this book, she makes the following heretical statements. Quote, everyone is obliged to be holy, even those who have no faith. Obviously, in the case of those who have no faith, the holiness will be that dictated by their own conscience. As I was saying, those who do not have the happiness of possessing the gift of faith are also bound to become holy by a dictate of the human conscience. The imposter Sister Lucia makes the heretical statement that those who have no faith can become holy. No one is holy unless they have baptism and the true Catholic faith. In Hebrews 11:6, St. Paul teaches, quote, without faith it is impossible to please God. In other words, without the faith it is impossible to be saved or to be holy. St. Paul teaches the opposite of the imposter Sister Lucia. She also denies the defined Catholic dogma that there is no salvation outside the Church. Pope Gregory XVI, Mirari Vos, number 13, August 15, 1832, quote, they should consider the testimony of Christ himself, that those who are not with Christ are against him, and that they disperse unhappily who do not gather with him. Therefore, without a doubt, they will perish forever unless they hold the Catholic faith whole and inviolate. The imposter Sister Lucia died on February 13, 2005. If you believe that this was the real Sister Lucia, then you believe that she lived to the age of 97. That is because the real Sister Lucia was born in 1907. An extremely small minority of people even reach the age of 90. In fact, in America, only 2% of Americans live to be 90 years old. The number of people who reached 100 years old was, quote, an estimated few thousand in 1950. So if you believe that Sister Lucia died in 2005, you believe that she was part of that extremely small percentage of people who lived to be 97. The following year after the imposter Sister Lucia's death, the Vatican announced that it would be releasing an unpublished document of 64 pages of writing by Sister Lucia that they entitled, quote, The Message of Fatima. In these writings, the imposter Sister Lucia stated about World War II, quote, the outbreak of an atheist war against the faith, against God and against the people of God, a war that sought to exterminate Judaism. In the Old Testament, the prophet Daniel made a prophecy about the Messiah, Jesus Christ, In Daniel 9, verse 26, he states, quote, "And after 62 weeks Christ shall be slain, and the people that shall deny him shall not be his." Daniel explicitly states that the people who deny Christ are not God's people. The Bible directly contradicts the impostor Sister Lucia and the Vatican II Church, who officially hold the position that the Jews are still the people of God. There are many people who believe that Sister Lucia was silenced, that writings have been attributed to her that she did not author. Anyone who claims to be a Catholic must admit that the book Calls, which contains incredible heresies, could not have been written by Sister Lucia. If the Vatican will go so far to forge writings and falsely attribute them to Sister Lucia, then it is not in any way far-fetched to believe that the Vatican would have gotten an impostor Sister Lucia, especially with the overwhelming evidence pointing directly to that conclusion. These same people believe that the Vatican is lying about the Third Secret. They believe that the Third Secret has not been revealed. It is not logical to believe in the Vatican's Sister Lucia while not believing in the Vatican's, quote, Third Secret. The two must go together. You cannot reject the Vatican's, quote, Third Secret without also rejecting their Sister Lucia as an impostor, because she confirmed the Vatican's Third Secret as being the real one. For those who find these facts too hard to accept, we ask them to focus on our Lord's statement that in the last days the deception will be so profound that even the elect will be deceived if that were possible, Matthew 24. And an impostor, Sister Lucia, was crucial to the devil's plan of deceiving the world on Fatima, because the real message of Fatima and the importance of the whole world knowing the true message contained in the Third Secret of Fatima concerns the salvation of countless people.